Chinese automobiles are actively conquering the world, offering incredible technical solutions for quite modest sums of money. But what's the catch? There's a belief that they are made from metal as thin as foil and plywood sheets to reduce costs, and that at the slightest accident or bump, your premium Chinese car will simply fall apart. But is this really the case? I've compiled the most illustrative crash tests, and at the end, I'll show what happens to the people's favorite, Chery Tiggo, if it collides with an obstacle. It's important to clarify that there are several main methodologies for evaluating car crash tests worldwide. Accordingly, car certification takes place where the vehicle is primarily intended to be sold. China was no exception, deciding to create its own certification, C-NCAP. Since its inception in 2006, China has refined its crash test methods, bringing them closer to the standards of the European Euro NCAP. These tests have been modified and complicated several times, but remain the primary tool for assessing vehicle safety. The Chinese counterpart, C-NCAP, now conducts tests similar to the European ones, but there are differences in approach. C-NCAP evaluates three key aspects – driver and passenger safety, pedestrian protection, and the effectiveness of active safety systems, while European standards also include tests for child protection. There are also differences in the crash test process and conditions. For example, in Europe, the speed at which the side impact occurs is slightly higher, and there's an assessment of frontal collision, not just impact against an obstacle. But overall, it's no longer possible to say that Euro NCAP is significantly more challenging than its Chinese counterpart. They're just a bit different. So among the cars I will show today, there will be European and Japanese brands familiar to us all to make comparisons possible. The premium Chinese brand Voyah, owned by the state corporation Dongfeng, debuted on the world market quite recently. Currently, this automaker is represented by the electric crossover Free and the minivan Dream. After the C-NCAP tests, Voyah 3 received a high overall safety score of a whopping 92.3% after all tests. The 2021 electric crossover was rated 94.39% for driver and passenger safety, 75.09% for pedestrian protection, and an astonishing 100% for the operation of electronic auxiliary systems. There's no higher score than this. The test results earned the model 5 stars in safety. The report noted minimal risk of injuries to the driver and passengers in various types of collisions. This success of Voyah 3 in safety completely breaks the stereotypes about the unreliability of Chinese cars and their auxiliary anti-crash systems. But it should be noted that the car's cost is corresponding, with the base configuration starting at almost $90,000, which is quite comparable to the same crossovers from German manufacturers, albeit with gasoline engines. And here's a car that has confidently burst onto the crossover market, offering the best price-quality ratio. But is everything really okay with it? The Chinese company Geely began accepting orders for its flagship Monjaro crossover in March 2023, though some dealers had already started independently importing this model since the end of the previous year. In China, this model is known as Xingyu L and successfully passed local crash tests, receiving the maximum safety rating, 5 stars. However, some observations were made about this car. In the crash test, a 2022 model car with 2-liter Volvo turbo engine, the most popular configuration to date, was used. The protection of the driver, passengers and children in the rear seat was rated a respectable 89.49%. The pedestrian safety score was 76.81%, and the car's safety system performance was rated at 82.01%. Analysis of results obtained from crash test dummies revealed a medium risk of chest injuries for a child in a car seat during a frontal collision with an immovable barrier at a speed of 50 km per hour. Though it sounds so-so, it's a pretty decent result. In a frontal collision with 50% overlap on a deformable obstacle, similar injuries could be sustained by the driver and the rear passenger. For pedestrians, the greatest danger comes from the side pillars and the hood area of the car. These shortcomings identified during testing should be addressed in the model's upcoming facelift to enhance its safety on public roads. If you find it hard to take information about Chinese cars in local crash tests seriously, here's a car that's familiar to everyone and popular worldwide. The Honda CR-V in China is produced by the joint venture between Honda Motor Company and Dongfeng Motor Corporation. In the Asian NCAP tests, an all-wheel drive version of this vehicle with a 1.5-liter petrol engine producing 193 horsepower was tested. During the tests, the Honda CR-V earned fairly high expert ratings. 90.07% for driver and passenger protection, and like with Gili, child protection was also tested, 80.56% for pedestrian safety and 88.09% for vehicle safety system performance. The analysis conducted on crash test dummies revealed a relatively medium risk of chest injuries to a rear passenger and head injuries to a child in a car seat during a frontal collision with an immovable barrier at a speed of 50 km per hour. The final rating? 5 safety stars, which means the maximum score. But overall, no one doubted this. As you can see, Honda is not far from Geely and other Chinese brands if we compare their overall scores in the same testing system. Not all Chinese cars receive 5 safety stars. The newcomer from China to the global market, the Changan Uni-V liftback, also went through C-NCAP crash tests. And this model's safety was rated at 4 stars. During the testing, the car scored 80.26% for driver and passenger protection, and pedestrian safety was rated at 69.23%, which affected the overall average score. The safety systems of the Chinese liftback were rated at 83.92%, even higher than the Japanese Honda CR-V. The main issue identified in the tests was that during a frontal collision with an immovable object, there is an increased risk of severe head injury for a child in the rear seat. But don't worry, most child seats solve this problem. There is also an increased risk of chest injury for a rear adult passenger in a side collision with a deformable object. However, the emergency braking system was assessed by experts as reliably working, receiving a high rating with a plus sign. And the most pleasing thing is that the price of these cars starts at $20,000, unlike the cars I talked about earlier. This is a quite budget-friendly and competitive option. But let's talk about modern electric cars, which are prophesied to have a great future. The four-door electric vehicle BYD Seal debuted in China in March 2022. This car, positioning itself as a competitor to Tesla Model 3, is equipped with a 530-horsepower dual-motor electric powertrain. Interestingly, this exotic newcomer can be purchased almost worldwide. Moreover, the results of Chinese crash tests suggest that there is no need to worry too much about the safety of this vehicle. Experts rated driver and passenger protection at 92.27%, though pedestrian safety was only 66.75%. Motorist assistance systems aiding safe driving received a high rating of 92.97%. Nevertheless, certain shortcomings were identified. The main danger for the driver is a side impact, posing a serious risk of chest injury. But most importantly, BYD Seal does not ignite like Tesla in case of collision. At least there have been no such incidents in 1.5 years. And the cost is quite reasonable. The car can be found starting at $30,000 with a fairly adequate configuration. But there might be a misleading impression that every Chinese product is the epitome of quality and reliability. Unfortunately, this is far from true. For example, the crossover Skyworth EV6 received an extremely low safety rating of just 1 star in the tests. This model is quite popular worldwide, just sold under different names. The funniest part is how the company representatives commented on the crash test results. They stated that the vehicle which underwent the C-NCAP crash test was a test sample. The variant that went on sale was much more reliable and safer. But why they haven't retested to dispel bias concerns is unclear. Skyworth EV6 scored only 38.45% for driver and passenger safety, practically failing all stages of the crash tests. The indicators obtained from the dummies showed high risks of various injuries for the driver and all passengers in all simulated collision scenarios. Interestingly, pedestrian safety was much better at 61.46%, implying that if you get run over by this wonder, you have more chances of surviving than sitting inside it. The Nissan X-Trail crossover is a model popular worldwide. It is also produced at the Dongfeng Nissan factory in China, hence it is subject to mandatory C-NCAP certification. These values will be indicative for us, as many are wary of Chinese cars, and here we have the opportunity to directly compare safety under equal conditions. You don't think that the Chinese make a downgraded version of the X-Trail for themselves, do you? Correctly, the Chinese version of the vehicle confidently gets 5 safety stars in crash tests. The test results showed driver and adult passenger safety at 89.04%, pedestrian safety at 70.26%, and the efficiency of electronic assistance systems at 84%. As you can see, compared to Geely or Voyah, it's even slightly worse in terms of safety, which is very telling. But we mainly looked at crossovers which confidently capture the car market. But how about business sedans? The Hongqi H5 business sedan from China, a classmate of the Mercedes-Benz E-Class and BMW 5 Series, successfully passed Chinese crash tests, earning an excellent rating and 5 safety stars. The level of driver and passenger protection was rated at 89.45%, pedestrian protection at 74.18%, and the performance of the car's electronic assistance at 93.38%. Despite high ratings, experts noted an increased likelihood of injuries for people inside the car. For example, during a frontal collision with an immovable barrier, an adult passenger and a child in the back seats may suffer chest and head injuries respectively. In a similar collision with a moving object, there is a moderate risk of leg injury to the driver. But overall, the car is no worse than its classmates. Even considering that the Chinese crash test might be easier than the European one, 5 stars is a result with a significant safety margin. And how about the really fast Chinese cars? The electric sedan NIO ET7 demonstrated outstanding results in C-NCAP tests, receiving 5-star rating. But that's not all. The Chinese also passed the European Euro NCAP certification, which confirmed such a high result. This is truly a safe and insanely beautiful car, not to mention its staggering power of 700 horsepower. The test organizers rated driver and passenger safety at 88.18%, other road users at 77.15%, and electronic assistance scored 91.44%. Experts particularly noted the very low risk of driver and passenger injuries in various collision scenarios. These results underscore the high safety level of the C-NCAP standard, despite opinions that the Chinese are self-rating stars. Again, if compared to Europeans, the Volkswagen ID.3 electric car for the Chinese market received the same 5 stars in crash tests as the NIO electric car. The main problem noted by experts is a high risk of chest and abdominal injuries for the driver in a frontal collision. However, besides this, no other significant issues were identified by the test organizers. The car received high ratings, 89.32% for driver and passenger protection and 85.98% for the performance of the car's safety systems, which is even lower than its Chinese counterpart. So draw your conclusions. And as promised, let's talk about the people's favorite, Chery Tiggo. As this car is sold in huge quantities worldwide, thanks to its budget-friendly price and rich features. The durability tests of the Tiggo 4 and Tiggo 7 Pro crossovers were conducted back in 2015. According to the results, the compact urban crossover Tiggo 4 scored 86.9% of the maximum possible result. Meanwhile, the most popular Chinese crossover Tiggo 7 Pro passed the test with even greater success, scoring 92% of the maximum points and receiving the coveted 5 stars, becoming the absolute leader of C-NCAP. This car achieved maximum results in the side test, as well as decent indicators in frontal and rear crash tests. The flagship 7-seater crossover Chery Tiggo 8, oriented for family use, underwent stricter criteria in 2018. The best result was achieved in a frontal crash test with partial overlap, 75% of the maximum points. The overall crash test rating was 85% of the maximum points, which also corresponds to 5 C-NCAP safety stars. In February 2023, the largest crossover Chery Tiggo 9 also successfully passed safety tests, and this time according to both Chinese and European standards. It is incorrect to say that Chinese cars are unsafe junk. It's a big misconception, as almost all the most popular models easily pass reliability and safety tests according to the strictest evaluation methods.